Hey loves, thanks so much for tuning in. I have a really cool DIY. Today I'm going to be showing you how to bling out your bar with some very simple items. As usual, I have everything listed in the description box. Let's go ahead and get started. So first I'm going to take this set of 4 wine glasses that I did get from Ross. They were $6.99 each. So these are seamless wine glasses. They have a beautiful little arch on the bottom of them. These are beautiful just as they are, but I wanted to go ahead and give them a little bit more pizzazz. So first take some painter's tape and apply it to your glass at the level that you want your glitter to show. So you're gonna go ahead and apply your tape to all of your glasses. Try to make sure that it's level and just about even on all of your glasses. Next, I'm gonna take some Mod Podge and pour it into a container. Then I'm gonna take some extra fine glitter and pour it into the Mod Podge. Take a paintbrush and stir it all together. Then you're gonna take your glass and you're gonna apply the Mod Podge to the bottom of your wine glass. So next I'll do the same for my bottles. If you wanna see how I created these bottles, I went ahead and I took some white spray paint and some metallic silver chrome spray paint, and I gave these Welch's sparkling, I think apple juice or whatever, a nice coating of spray paint. I'm gonna go ahead and apply the same Mod Podge and glitter method to these as well. So next I'm gonna take some more of my fine glitter. I'm gonna apply it over the Mod Podge because I want it to be super sparkly. You always want to make sure you put a paper plate underneath your glitter so you can catch everything and recycle it. I'm going to set this aside and let it dry for a few minutes. I'll apply the same method to this bottle as well. So to contrast the colors, I'm going to use this lighter pink fine glitter and apply it on top of the silver glitter. Here's what this one will look like. I'm gonna set this aside as well and allow them all to dry. So next, I'm gonna show you how to make a blinged out ice bucket using a paint pail. I got this from Michael's. It was $7.99. I also am gonna be using some bling wrap that I got from Michael's. So first, I'm gonna remove the top of my paint pail. I've been in this cell too long. So I'm gonna place my handle up top and I'm gonna wrap my bling wrap all the way around. I'm gonna take your scissors and cut it. Next, I'm gonna take some E6000 and apply it to my paint pail, and then I'm going to add my bling wrap on top of that all the way around. So next I'm going to take one of these beautiful diamond doorknobs. I got these on Amazon. I used them to make these beautiful cubbies right behind me. And I'm going to apply it to the top of my paint pail. So here's what your ice bucket will look like once you've went ahead and you added your beautiful handle right on the top, blinged it out. I love this. I think it's very creative, very innovative. I couldn't find an ice bucket that I really liked, so I decided to make one on my own. So next, what I'm gonna do to my bottles is I'm gonna place a little brooch on here. I got these from Michael's, they're very small. I'm gonna place it on the center. Also, I'm gonna add some rhinestone. So I'll take my brooch and I'm gonna add some hot glue to the back of it. Place your brooch in your desired location. Next, I'm gonna take some adhesive gemstones and I'm gonna apply them on the side of the brooch, like so. I'm gonna just cut the roll that I'm gonna be using. I'm going to individually place the gemstones on the bottom. So here's what it will look like. I tried to go ahead and evenly place my gemstones all the way around. So you'll do the same on the other side. Next, what I'm gonna do is take this letter C. It's just a paper mache number. It looks like one of these. This is a different font, but these are just paper mache, like little letters. All I do is just put spray paint on them and then put glitter on top of them, and it looks like this. Super simple. So next, I'm gonna take my letter C and I'm gonna hot glue it to the front of my bottle. And here's what it will look like. I love this. You can definitely dress it up more if you want to. I just want to keep it simple since it already had a lot going on with it. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and design my last bottle. On this bottle here, I'm gonna take some more of the Mod Podge and apply the silver glitter on top of the pink. It didn't pop out as much as I wanted it to, so I'm gonna go ahead and cover it up just a little bit with some more silver glitter. Add some more silver glitter. So I know this one's still wet, but I'm gonna go ahead and add my brooch to this one as well. And I added this one a little bit higher. I like that a whole lot better. I'm gonna go ahead and add my gemstones to this one as well. So this time I went ahead and I added the gemstones at the top. I like that look a whole lot better. There's a line with the bottle already. I just followed that. So lastly, I'm gonna take this wooden C letter that I got from Michael's. It was already painted white. I think it's actually magnetic. And I'm going to hot glue it to the front of my bottle. This may change. I hope it looks right. Hope it doesn't take away from how fabulous it already is. So I'm gonna go ahead and add hot glue to the letter. I really do like this. So that's what the last bottle will look like. You can put on yours whatever you like. Mine's may change, who knows. And I'm gonna set this aside and allow this to dry. So lastly, you're gonna remove your painter's tape from the bottom of your wine glasses. Here's what they will look like. Super cute. I'm gonna pull the tape off of all of these. And that is how you bling out your bar essentials. I hope you enjoyed today's DIY. I'll have everything listed in the description box. If you're watching this video and you are not subscribed, take a moment, hit that subscribe button. No, hit that subscribe button right now. Thank you so much. Also, hit the notification bell. I'll be back really soon with another DIY. Have a blessed day. Bye.